My name is Jawad Qureshi, and I am entomologist at the Southwest Florida Research and Education Center in Immokalee, Florida. You have heard in the earlier talks reference made to the biological control in different contexts, and I am specifically going to talk about the biological control of the Asian citrus psyllid, ACP, abbreviated as ACP. And the biological control was one of the important components of citrus pest management before psyllid invaded in Florida and continued to be even after that, despite we went on a treadmill of chemical control. So these three groups, the predators, the parasitoids, and the entomopathogens, are the ones where several species have been shown to contribute to the mortality of this insect. Most of my talk will be focused on the predators and parasitoids. So I'll touch a base with entomopathogens as well. So if you are in the grove and you are looking for this insect or the beneficial activity, there you will mainly find them on the newly developing shoots where this insect, the adults, they like to feed and they reproduce and their young ones are developing. The adults are about 2 millimeter and you will see 100 of eggs in these newly developing buds and shoots, and then they go through 5 nymphal stages before they transform to the adult stage. A single female can lay several hundred eggs, so multiple control methods, especially biological control, we need that to keep suppressing their populations. And you all know that it's economically important because of the HLB factor. So among predators, we have several groups, several species, and lady beetles, lacewings, and spiders that are out there in the groves and have been shown to contribute to nature mortality of this insect. Similarly, we have done some work to show that some of these species that are commercially available and were never tested before, lady beetles, lacewings, and even a predatory mite, that they do have a potential to contribute to the mortality of this insect. Two parasitoids were released in Florida after psyllid invaded, and Tamaraxia radiata, the one here in the picture, is the one that is established and contribute to the nature mortality of Asian citrus psyllid. Among the entomopathogens, we see a good contribution from Hirsutella citriformis, naturally occurring fungus. It's very common in the commercial groves, although not available commercially. While the other two, they are found in the groves as well as available commercially. So if you are out there and looking for these beetles, that's how they look. This is their larval stage, and these are the adult stages. So they may not look pretty as developing, but definitely they look beautiful when they are adult stages. And this is the Olavi nigrum. This species responded to the psyllid invasion after it came into Florida. It was not common in the groves before, but after that, its number escalated. You will see this black body with these red spots on the wings, and then you will see this lining around the pronotum, the part behind the head, to distinguish it. Usually it's not difficult to distinguish it. It can only be confused with another species, which is called twice-stabbed lady beetle. In that case, these spots will be more rounded, and you will not see this white marking. This is the blood red lady beetle. As the name says, you will see this body, most of its body, orange to red color, with no spots, and you will see these lines around the pronotum, which will give appearance that it's wearing a wide-rimmed sunglasses. So it's also very, very easy to distinguish. So they both are very good predator of Asian citrus psyllid and several other pests. Then we have this multicolored Asian lady beetle. You will see more variability in its appearance. You can see the background as yellow, orange, or red. And then either you will see these spots on the body or there may not be any spot. Then we have this metallic blue lady beetle. They glean iridescent blue in the sunlight, and it's very easy to see them and not to confuse with any other species. So they not only target the Asian citrus psyllid, but they are also a very good predator of several other pests. Most of them target the aphids and mites, and they are also very good predators of scales and mealybugs. And some of the species have, we have published a paper recently on Curinus corallius and the Florida red scale, which is covered with that armor and hard to get, but these species will go and take out that armor and take care of the females and the crawlers underneath those structures. So we did some studies to look at the impact of how these naturally occurring predators are having an impact on the psyllid populations. And I just simplified that study into two treatments where we had the shoots with the psyllid colonies protected with the cages or left unexposed available to the predators. And what we observed that those nature factors were taking out more than 80% populations of this insect. So if they were protected from them, you can see the population growth of Asian citrus psyllid without this natural factor of mortality. So of course, we have used a lot of insecticides during the almost two decades because of the Asian citrus psyllid and Huanglong Bing. But we still see a good level of nature mortality in the groves. This is data from one of my students who graduated last year. His project was basically to look at the psyllid response to the changing planting density in Asian citrus psyllid and how biological control responds to that. And we were still seeing a good level of nature mortality averaging from 50% to around 70%. And these were multiple cohorts done during the 2 years. I am just showing the data for the two incidences. And he was also trying to get an assessment of the indicators that he was finding out there. And he was seeing lacewing spiders and lady beetles. Among the lady beetles, still these four species that I showed, they were out there, dominated by Olavi nigrum and Curinus corallius. Followed by Cyclonida singuina and Harmonia exiridus. Lacewings, especially the genus Chrysoperla and Cerochrysa, these are also another important group that attack psyllid and several other pests. We have been studying them in relation to different studies, including looking at their dominance in different management systems that we have been testing, combining conventional organic insecticide or biological control. But overall, we have seen one species, Cerochrysa cubana, that is very dominant in most of the production systems. In general, the populations of predators have gone down over the past decade and a half. The reason being on the treadmill of insecticide use, and lady beetle seems to be most impacted. That's what we have seen through the drop in their numbers that we see over the years. Considering those concerns, my lab is also looking at some of the commercial species that are available and looking at some basic evaluation and seeing if they have the potential. Adelia bipunctata is one species that is commercially available, and we have seen that it can develop and reproduce on the diet of the Asian citrus psyllid. We also tested them out in the grove using the cages, caging those beetles with the developing colonies of Asian citrus psyllid, and they also did a great job there. You can see these white hollow bars. It tells you the number of nymphs that were in the colonies, and these black bars within those bars show you the percentage consumption of the adult of those lady beetles. So they show good potential, at least an option out there. Same thing in the lacewings group. This is a commercially available species, and you can see the adult and larva of this species feeding on the nymphs of Asian citrusilin. We also showed that it developed and reproduced on the diet of the psyllid and tested under semi-field condition in the cages on the citrus trees in the field. And again, we see that it also does a reasonable level of predation, consuming up to 35% of the colonies on which they were tested. On the previous slide, I forgot to mention, there was an average of about 54% reduction with the testing of the lady beetles in nymphal colonies. So for this lacewing, we also tested different release rates in a study that was done in a greenhouse using a bug dome cages and about 100 or so eggs and nymph of Asian citrusillid per plant. And we released 2, 4, and 6 adults per cage. And you can see that with increasing predator populations, there was a significant increase in the mortality, averaging from about 43 to 81% in psyllid immatures. A couple of years ago, I had an intern from Spain in my lab, and she looked at the impact of a predatory mite, Amblycius swirskii, which is commercially available. And in those studies also, she found a good impact of that mite on the eggs of Asian citrusillid and the first instar nymphs, which are the new nids, very young nymphs of the psyllid. And this is the graph showing the plants on which the mites were released compared to where there were no mites, and the psyllids that came out of those plants after about 8 weeks since we made the release. The parasites Tamarax irradiata, several of you were out there looking them. I had on the setup under the microscope. This parasite was released in Florida soon after psyllid invaded from its original locations in Taiwan and Vietnam. Later on, we brought some more from the same region and China and Pakistan, and the VNF plant industry is mass producing and releasing this parasite in the state and also provided to growers over the years. The female lays its eggs on the underside of the nymph. The larva consumes the body contents of the nymph, pupates, and finally the adult comes out from the mummified nymph by chewing a hole in the thoracic region, and that's how the life cycle is completed. We have been testing this parasite for several years in different experiment situation, depending upon the studies. This is one example from a study that we did for about 4 or 5 years, testing organic and conventional programs. And as you see, at a straight conventional program with hard chemistries doesn't give them much chance to survive and establish in those environment. But the organic programs or the untreated environments, or I don't show it here, but we have data where you provide combinations of conventional and selective, provide them some a chance to survive and contribute to the nature mortality. And considering an insect, I would like to mention here that any single Asian citrusillid that we take out is a contribution, considering that insect has a potential of laying a couple of hundred eggs, and considering a sex ratio of 50-50, the females that you destroy with a single female of this parasite, if you make those numbers, it becomes a huge contribution in the overall picture. The populations and the impact of this parasite was also tested by David Hall and one of his students, Eric Rorick, in the urban environments. They made some releases of this parasite in the hedges of orange jasmine. That's another host that psyllid loves to feed and reproduce. And they found it established there and found peristaltism rates averaging from about 16 to 35% per shoot. So we have seen a good contribution over the years and still continue to see from these predators and parasites to the mortality of and suppression of Asian citrus psyllid populations. So what can we do in our capacity to conserve those populations and contribute to the augmentation efforts which at any level are happening? These beneficial insects are expected to be more common during the growing season because that's when most of the trees are producing the new growth, and that new growth is attraction to the Asian citrus psyllid, to leaf miner, aphids, and several other pests. So we need to be careful with our selection of what we spray during the growing season. So with more selective options, we can provide room for these beneficial insects to contribute their role. And of course, if we go with the dormant sprays, we can use the hard insecticides to target the dormant application populations of Asian citrus psyllid so that we have a good suppression before we start the season in spring. So to achieve the goal of overall integrated and being on the path of sustainability for citrus pest management, we require all the tools, and biological control is one of the significant in that picture. With that, I would like to thank several of the funding sources over the years, private industry, growers, Division of Plant Industry, and my lab group that work hard to bring all this to you. And thank you very much for your patience.